If you have a small account, there's a way that you can use options to enhance your returns, and I'm going to be talking about that in this video. So a few minutes ago, I was going through all my screens and I came across a stock that has just reported earnings. And if you take a look at this, you'll see Hasbro pops on strong earnings. The reason? Turnaround efforts. So the stock was trading higher after the toy maker beat quarterly estimates for earnings and sales. Well, that's good. We like companies that beat earnings and sales. We don't like to go into companies that are having earnings and sales. But once they report, it's a little bit safer. Now, there's still some volatility the day or two after, but you can take advantage of that if you want to use something called what I call synthetics, which are known as spreads or verticals. There's all different kinds of terms for it. So that's the article on bearings. I want to show you the chart, though. And this is an interesting chart because if you look over here, now this is a weekly chart, you can see it's about 103% of its average daily volume. This is a weekly, average weekly volume. So it's up. I like to have it up more than 40 or 50% on its weekly volume. This is up, you know, 100% on its weekly volume. So it's double the volume. And at the end of the day, this is going to be a wicked wick of a candle, okay? So let's take a look at it. You can see, first of all, the red line is going up through the black line. We're getting ready to. That's called a golden cross. That's when a lot of institutions start to come in, is when the 50-day, or in this case, the 10-week moving average, crosses up through the 40-week moving average or the 200-day, same thing. 50 up through the 200 or 10-week through the 40. Same thing. On this one, it's a weekly chart. So we've got a huge candle on high volume. When you do price volume analysis, that's an important thing. Now, what that does is it puts this swing point into play. This swing point looks to be about, I don't know, let's call it 75 maybe, something like that. So that means this stock is at 65 and there's 75 in play. Now, of course, this stock could come back down and test these moving averages, and sometimes they do that. And we are, by the way, in a red market. So I don't like to recommend these, but sometimes when I see them, I just want to bring them to your attention. So you can say, hey, listen, I want to see how the methodology works or do my own research or whatever. All right. So that's how the chart looks. Over here on the left side, you can see that the earnings 2022 were 445, but they dropped a lot last year to 251. And now they're expected to go back up approximately 31% is the earnings estimates, and then continuing up next year in 2025. So that all is really good. I don't like the fact that their sales have slowed down and their earnings are kind of mixed, but the fact that they're doing a turnaround effort and that they have just beat earnings, I think are two good things. So anyway, how does this work out? Let's take a look at it. Well, first of all, what we're going to do is we're going to buy the call using a synthetic. So instead of buying the stock, now we could buy the stock, it's pretty cheap, but if you know, it's $65 a share, but that means you have to have $6,500 for 100 shares. We can also substitute the stock for a synthetic, right? A deep in the money call. I like to go deep in the money calls, which has about a 90 delta. That gives me a pretty good correlation to the direction that the stock is moving, and I think it's got a slight upward probability right now. And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to go here to the delta, and I look at the delta, it's 89.7. That's pretty close to 90. So I'm going to buy that option, the 50 strike price option, for 1620. Then what I'm going to do is I'm going to turn around and I'm going to go out 57 days, okay? So that option was, by the way, that $50 option was 176 days out. So that one's 6 months out. But this call is out 57 days, so 2 months out. So it's a spread that goes out. I'm going to go in the money slightly, right? The stock is at 65.20, something like that. I'm going to get 285 for the bid. So that's what I want to do, is I'm going to sell the 65 against, just slightly in the money, and I'm going to pick up $2.85 for it. $2.64 of that is what I call juice, which is basically your income. Now, here's what has to happen. The stock needs to stay above 65. So this is a bullish strategy. I believe that the stock is going to stay above 65. If it doesn't, that's okay. I like the stock. I'm going to collect that $2.64 no matter what. But the most I could make on this stock is if it stays above 65, which it already is. So the probabilities of it being above 65, you know, maybe you can look at it. They're pretty good. Well, they're better than it being under 65 just because it's already over 65, right? So if we get a market upturn, if we get the stock continuing to do upturns, if people are now starting to pile in because it's got a golden cross, there's a lot of things that could keep the stock above 65. So that's how I'm looking at it. Let's take a look at the numbers. So the stock is at 65.21, and we are buying the synthetic instead of buying the stock, so it's about a fourth of the price, roughly, and so I'm paying $16.20 for the $50 call. I'm selling against it the $2.85, getting $2.85 for those $65 at the money call, or just slightly in the money. You can see that there. I'm gonna do 2,000 shares, which is basically 20 contracts, and it's got a 57 days for the initial sell before it expires. So let's look at the numbers. I bring my basis down from 16.20, and because I get $2.85 in income, I bring my basis down to 13.35. So the stock can decrease a couple of bucks, and I still haven't really lost money. So that's good. I get a little bit of cushion. You know, if you eventually do this over and over again, eventually you pay for the whole stock. That's kind of the idea in the mentality that I like to instill in my students. The juice calculated is about $2.64. It's a 16% raw return, or you can look at it as a 19.78, you know, calculated return, because I take down the income that we get, and that's really our basis. So if you annualize it, let's say you could do this trade, you know, six times this year, you would end up getting 127%. What is that 127%? Well, let's say that it's unrealistic, okay? First of all, let's be honest here. You're not gonna probably do it five, six times in a row. Maybe you will. But if you don't, you're not gonna get the 127%. But it allows you to compare this particular opportunity against other particular opportunities, okay? So this is a covered call strategy, but instead of using the stock, we are using the synthetic. And I think you could see on a $26,000 investment, you can end up making about $5,280, or 20%. Now, remember, it has to stay above 65 for you to get all of that, right? If it goes below 65, you got a little cushion because you're getting $2.64 worth of juice to catch you, $2.85 of total premium to catch you. But obviously the risk, if this Hasbro doesn't stay up here and it goes down a lot, well, then you have to do some trade adjustments and you have to do some other things, or you just sell the whole position altogether. There's no risk. There's no reward without risk in the market, right? You know that. But anyway, thought that was an interesting one for you. If you want to know how I do this, you know, I've got some links below. You can subscribe to my newsletter so you get these automatically. Anyway, I'll see you on the next video. Take care.